Mr. Parkin goes first. His choice is electronic music. He, of course, has had no preparation for this. It isn't like one of those other shows where they get weeks to bone up on their special subject and go through it with their wife and entire family. Electronic music, the work of Pierre Schaffer at the studios of French radio in the 1940s, is regarded as pioneering in that he was the first to use sound effects on tape to create new musical forms. What French phrase did he apply to this technique?
Music concrète.
Music concrète is the right answer. Here's an extract from one of the best-known works of electronic music in the 1950s. I'd like you to tell me who composed it. Voices in Nebuchadnezzar's furnace. Process of composing electronic music was revolutionized by the introduction in 1965 of a synthesizer which bears the name of its American inventor. Who was it?
Robert Moog.
Robert Arthur Moog. Yes, Moog, Moog. There are two O's. Would you say Moog or Moog? I've always said Moog, but never mind. You've got the voice. It is pronounced Moog, is it? Oh, the experts over there are saying, oh, Lord, the dads we've got over there. Another revolutionary instrument used by many popular musicians and serious composers alike was first demonstrated in the Soviet Union in 1920. Playing it involved waving the hands around its antenna and loop, thus creating audible oscillations, but never actually touching the instrument. What was it called?
The theremin.
Yes, I think in this case we don't pronounce the H, do we? I don't know how Mr. Godfrey and Mr. Moore feel, but they're definitely a point of adjudicators at the moment. Young Grove has bowed out at this one. Mr. Parkin, here comes a very well-known piece of music indeed. That was in 1963. Who was the composer of that piece?
Ron Grainer.
Ron Grainer, yes, indeed. He also wrote the themes for Steptoe, May Graham. That was the week that was, 40 years ago this year. Which American composer's works composed largely on electronic instruments include the opera Akhenaten and the film scores Koyaanisqatsi and Pauhkwatsi?
Philip Glass.
Correct answer. Did I disturb you with the pronunciations there, or were you able to write? More music now from a German group who pioneered electronics in popular music. This piece provided them with their greatest commercial success. Which group is this? The group?
Kraftwerk.
Kraftwerk, yes, yes, yes. No, we'll agree on that. The model became a number one hit in 1982, 4 years after its initial release. Now, finally, because you're absolutely impregnable so far, finally, which rock group achieved hits with electronic arrangements of classical compositions such as Mussorgsky's Pictures and Exhibition and Copland's Fanfare for the Common Man?
Emerson, Lake and Palmer.
Yes, Keith Emerson, Greg Lake and Carl Palmer, and you've got a totally complete round there. You had two in the first one, 16 in that one, 18.